my dear students, I hope all of you are fit and fine. Today we will be discussing a new chapter of general knowledge and the name of the topic is Space and Stars, lesson number 35, page number 41, Space and Stars. Okay, first of all I would like to say, like to admit something, that when you some of you have already opened today's study material and you might have felt like the study material of today, it appears to be a little bit dull because there is no picture in that study material, particularly of today. And this is the first time that I have not attached any picture. Trust me, when I was making the study material, as always I attach pictures. Today also I did that, but when I was transforming it into PDF, I don't know why, actually I was making it in my laptop, and when I was taking it into my phone, transferring it from laptop to phone, in my phone's MS Word, the pictures were not in the proper place. I mean, they got puzzled, I don't know why, due to some unknown problems. But from next time onwards, I will do that in my phone. I will try to do that. And I hope in most of the study materials, I would attach pictures as I always do. So try to compromise today and go through the study material. Please don't skip it just because it has no pictures. Look at the pictures, see the pictures provided in your book. I hope you will be a little bit entertained. Okay, space and stars. Space means a boundless area, limitless area, obviously, where all objects have their own position and direction. A huge ball holding spheroid of plasma together is known as a star. So this is important. What is a star? Sun is the nearest star to the Earth. This is also a very important information. Which is the nearest star to the Earth? The Sun. I think all of you already know that. Fill in the blanks using the help box. First one, a group of stars forming a pattern is known as, it would be a constellation. Okay. The second option here, in the help box, constellation. But let me zoom it. The font has also, it looks small in my phone. If you face any problem to read the font, you please zoom it. Okay, zoom it out. A constellation is a certain form on the visible space in which a group of visible stars form a perceived outline or pattern, typically representing an animal, mythological person or creature, or an inanimate object. Orion, Leo, Cancer are examples of such constellations. You please excuse me one second, my glasses are a little bit dirty, I guess. You just excuse me one second. Okay, now it's better. Now the second one, an extremely small star that does not shine brightly is known as dwarf star. Okay, the answer will be dwarf star. Dwarf stars are classified as any star of average or low luminosity, mass and size. Important subclasses of dwarf stars are white dwarfs and red dwarfs. Sun is such an example of dwarf star. This information has been mentioned in your book also in the fact section, that Sun is a dwarf star. And there are two types of dwarf stars. Subclasses of dwarf stars are red dwarf star, and white dwarf star. Okay. Now the third one, objects in space like stars, planets, they are known as celestial objects. Okay, the fill in the blanks, the blank would be filled with the word celestial. Celestial objects By definition, it is a natural object that lies on observable space outside of the Earth's atmosphere. Stars, planets, moons, solar system, galaxies, meteors are classified as celestial objects. The font is really small in my phone. I'm facing problem to read it. Okay. You just zoom it. Okay. Oh, another thing that I forgot to mention in dwarf star, in the explanation of dwarf star, dwarf stars are classified. Okay. It would be stars. If it is star, it would be is. We read grammar, na? So this would be dwarf stars. I have already uploaded the study material. So you please make it correct. Dwarf stars are classified as any star, or dwarf star is classified. It would be better. Dwarf star is classified as any star of average or low immunity dot not immunity luminosity dot dot dot. Okay, dwarf star is classified. If possible, I would edit it and then re-upload it. If not, if you find it like this, you please make it correct. Okay. Now the fourth one, small pieces of matter found in space is known as cosmic dust. Cosmic dust, also called this is a very tough word. Cosmic dust, also called extraterrestrial dust or space dust, are tiny particles of solid material which float in outer space or has fallen on Earth. Okay, both the cases are possible. Cosmic dust is important because it helps young stars to form, and it is also the raw material from which planets like the Earth are formed. That is why cosmic dust is important. It has importance. Why? Because it helps the new or young stars to form, to get the proper form. Okay. And our Earth is one of them who got help from cosmic dust. Anyway, the next one, fifth one, an object which revolves around the Earth and can be seen shining at night in the sky is known as the moon. We all know about it. Still, I'm reading whatever I have mentioned. Moon is Earth's sole natural satellite and nearest large celestial body. It revolves around Earth and can be seen shining at night in the sky as its surface reflects light coming from the sun. Okay. Here also there is a typing mistake. Okay, I will edit these things, rectify these things, and will re-upload it. No problem. Okay. Now next one, a large piece of rock coming towards Earth with a bright light is known as meteor. So a meteor is the streak of bright light that we see in the sky when a small piece of celestial enters the atmosphere at high speed and burns up because of the frictional heating from the pieces collision with Earth's atmosphere. It has a great speed. Now that's why, because of the collision, the frictional speed and the collision, it burns. Okay, the next one, dash is the initial stage of a star, nebula, not the nebula of Guardians of Galaxy. This is nebula, which is the initial stage of a star. A nebula is a distinct body formed by interstellar clouds, gas, dust, and other similar objects. Nebula are known as star forming region. Wait, let me zoom it. Star forming region or initial stage of star, as the formations of gas, dust, and other materials clump together to form denser regions which attract further matter and eventually will become dense enough to form stars. Okay, you just remember about this. I think it would be a little bit tough for you to remember all these things. You just try to remember that nebula is the initial stage of a star. About this, you just remember this. Okay, nothing else. Okay, number 8. The dash process takes place in the core of sun to produce energy, the fusion process. Fusion is the process that powers the sun and the stars. It is the reaction in which atoms combine together or fuse to form an atom of different component. In the process, some of the mass of the former components are converted into energy. That's how the energy is produced. Okay, and because of the process, the sun or whatever there is, it gets the energy. Okay, due to this process. Now number 9. Dash is the moon of Jupiter. It's Ganymede. The pronunciation is Ganymede. Ganymede, a satellite of Jupiter, is the largest and most massive of the solar system's moons. Okay, important thing to remember. The 9th largest object of the solar system, it is the largest without a substantial atmosphere. So this point is really important. It is the largest moon of the solar system and the 9th largest object. Among all the things, it is the 9th largest one, and among the moons, it is the first one, first large one. Okay, I mean the largest one among the moons. Okay, the last but not the least, the second biggest planet of the solar system is Saturn. Okay, I think you already know this. Saturn is the second largest planet of our solar system in mass and size, and the 6th nearest planet in distance to the sun. In distance to the sun, not to the earth. Saturn has the most numbers of natural satellites. This is also important. The last two points, Ganymede and Saturn, the information that has been provided in study material, it is very important. Okay, other things you can memorize from book only, but the last two points you try to memorize the information provided in the study material, and the typing mistakes I am trying to rectify them and re-upload the study material after deleting the previous one. So I think you are going to get the correct one. If not, if I face any problem while re-uploading it, you just make the things correct wherever the typing mistake you can find. Okay, and do submit the worksheet positively. It is important. It's not that GK is, you know, interesting. Every day we come to, whenever we discuss in a new chapter, we come to know new information. Even along with you, I also come to know about different things, different new information, because I don't know everything about GK. GK is vast. GK is limitless, just like the universe. Okay, the universe has no boundary and general knowledge also has no boundary. So we always learn something whenever we read this subject. So this is interesting. You just, the worksheet will prove that, okay, you are watching the video, you are going through the chapter, you are learning things, and thus you can answer the questions and submit the worksheet. Otherwise, what will be proved? That no, you are not following any class, any video, any book or anything. That is why you are not submitting. Don't let anyone think that. Don't let me think that. Prove that you are watching, you are giving effort. Okay, so do submit the worksheet positively. Take care. Bye bye. We will meet in the next live class. Okay.